Now, Chief Meteorologist Scott Norvell with the On Your Side forecast.
It is Monday and time for another Climate Matters Monday segment. I like to do this each Monday, taking a look at some aspect of our climate, either around the world, nationally, or in Idaho. And today, our topic, taking a look at the data from the National Weather Service, warming at all levels. This is the temperature change since 1970 as compared to average. You take a look at the United States, when you add up all the weather stations, about 2.5 degrees of warming since 1970. And Idaho's pretty much right on tap with that, with a 2.6 degrees. Notice how Boise, though, is 3.8 degrees warmer than it was in 1970. The disparity here could be, again, I'm just looking at this, could be the urban heat island effect. With so many people moving in, bigger cities tend to warm up a little bit. So that may be the case right here. Anyway, you can get more information from climatecentral.org if you'd like to dig into this a little bit deeper. Our temperature history over just a little while ago shows a huge change. We've had all that cool weather at the beginning of April. Then it switched mid-April, and look at that swing up to 82 degrees on Friday. Now we're still in the 60s and some 70s here. The next 10 days, you see the 70s returning. We will shoot up to near 77, another near 80 degree coming in on Thursday, 80 degree day, and then dropping again towards the weekend with the coolest weather maybe coming in around this time next week. But even then, it's only just a little bit below average at 62. But when you bring the cooler weather in, typically it's a breeze that's doing that. So we may have a breeze over the weekend, but there's not a lot of precipitation in my forecast here as well. And then the beginning of May, heading to right about normal, right about what you'd expect for this time of year, sitting right around 63 or so. Look at the snow here in McCall. Look at the ice right here between the docks as it's beginning to thaw. Boy, it's taking a while. That's actually a McCall with all that snow on the ground still. It's 45 now, but it was near 60 today and will be for the next few days, so that snow will continue to melt steadily. So if you look at our Boise Basin snowpack, we show you the snowpack numbers all the time. It's about 126% of average. The Boise Basin is right here. All the snow here will melt into the Boise River. So that's the Boise Basin. So right now, it's at 126% of average, so where it should be for this time of year. It's dropping off. We're losing water content as it's flowing down into the reservoirs. Still 30 inches of water content on average there. Look at the three reservoirs that we have. 79% full. That's Anderson Ranch. That's the biggest reservoir. That's up 6% from last week. Arrow Rock is up 6% from last week as well. Three quarters full. Lucky Peak, they've been making more space in Lucky Peak, so you're seeing it drop a little bit, but there's still more water heading into the entire reservoir system. That's how we know that we're seeing an increase. 3% more water this week than last week. And the inflow of water is 14,000 CFS. So if we didn't have a reservoir system and dams to slow the water down, to allot the water out as a controlled flow, we'd have 14,000 CFS coming down the Boise River, and that wouldn't be good. That would be a flood. Right now, 6,500 CFS is coming out of Lucky Peak, but that's not what's coming down the Boise River, because the New York Canal has under 1,000 CFS right now at 800. This will go up as the demand for water comes in the summertime. So what's left going down the Boise River right now? The flow at the Glenwood Bridge anyway is at about 5,300 CFS. So there's a look at the flow. Everything's going right on schedule. Let's hope it's a controlled melt here so we don't get any more flooding. This is our little front right here. Could bring a couple of showers to central Idaho during the day tomorrow. The cooler weather to the north will stay to the north. I think the warmer weather will win out. We'll get a secondary surge coming in on Thursday, and our temperatures will go up, which is great news. Here's tomorrow afternoon. You still see just a slight chance for a shower, mostly in the mountains. But for the Treasure Valley for tomorrow, temperatures are coming up. Everybody will get into the mid 70s, even into the western parts of the valley, where it will be a little bit warmer, maybe 77 or 78. Sunshine and then partly cloudy in the afternoon, while mountain locations will once again hit 60 degrees. Watch out for a shower in the mountains, central mountains, the west central mountains especially. But boy, the valleys looks nice. 77 on Thursday. It may cool off into the weekend, but you know what? Sun, some clouds, comfortable weather.
Hey, we're on the backside of April. Closer to May than March, right?
Yes, we are, and the weather's behaving.
All right, thanks, Scott. They're back.